Hi guys, thank you so much for watching and welcome back to my channel. Today's look is going to be a get ready with me video. It's going to be hair and makeup. So if you're interested in seeing how I got this look, then please keep on watching. First thing I always do when getting ready is I do my hair first. So today I'll be using the Bedhead Wave Artist and I'm just holding this lightly on my hair. Personally, I have straight hair, so I don't have any type of volume, wave, or anything else under the sun in my hair. So I'm just holding it lightly to get a really loose wave, but as you prefer, you can hold it tighter, looser, longer, doesn't really matter. Anytime I do any type of curl or wave to my hair, every like 3 to 4 curls or waves, I usually just spray hairspray. Today I'll be using the Bedhead Masterpiece Massive Shine Hairspray. I'm just doing a really nice light layer of hairspray just to get a little bit of volume. Then when I'm done with all my waves, I do go in one more time with my hairspray. Personally, I don't like any hair on my face when I'm doing my makeup, so I do go in with like a 1970s scrunchie, and I just plop that at the top of my head. To start out this makeup look, I will be going with my Nerium AD Age Defying Day Cream, and I'm just putting this all over my skin. For primer today, I'm going to be going in with my Makeup Forever Step 1 Skin Equalizer, and this is a base corrector for redness, like a correcting primer. It has like a light tintish green to it, and if for anybody that doesn't know, if you have redness to your skin, green will conceal every little bit of it. And I have had a lot of redness in my skin lately, so that's why I just picked this one up, and I do love it. I absolutely love it. Today I'm going to be mixing 2 foundations, 2 droplets of my CoverFX Custom Cover Drops, and my CoverGirl Tone Rehab. And I'm starting on my forehead and then taking a damp beauty blender and just blending that all in. I'm then just going in and doing my normal eyebrow routine with my Anastasia Dip Brow and Brow Wiz. To prime my eyelids today, I'll be taking my Lorac Behind the Scenes Eye Primer, and this actually comes with the palette I'll be using, so that's a pretty cool little gig, and I'm just putting this all over my eyelids. To set my eyeshadow primer, I'm going to be using my Revlon Colorstay Pressed Powder. For eyeshadow today, I'll be using my Lorac Pro Eyeshadow Palette number 2, and the first color I'll be taking is the color Rose, and this is just going into my crease. And I'll just be blending this upwards as a nice transition color. The next color I'll be layering onto my crease is Nectar. I'm then taking the color Mocha and putting this all over my lid. Then taking the color Cocoa, I'll be adding this to the outer V of my eye and blending upwards along with a business card just so I get that perfect straight edge. Then just taking a clean blending brush, I'm just going to be blending all those colors together just so they look seamless. To highlight my brow bone, I'll be using the color Snow. For mascara today, I'll be using my MAC Cosmetics False Lashes. I'm then just going back in with my mixture of foundations and blending downwards along with my Damn Beauty Blender to blend this all in. For concealer today, I'll be using my Lorac Porefection Concealer. And this is just going underneath my eyes and then being blended out with my Damn Beauty Blender. Right after blending out my concealer, I quickly go in to set my concealer. Today, I'll be using my Laura Mercier Loose Setting Powder in the color Translucent. I adore this powder. This powder is bomb. It does not make any creases underneath my eyes. It's super light, and I just absolutely love it. To contour my face, I'll be using my Too Faced Soulmates Blushing Bronzer Illuminator in the color Carrie and Big. And this is just going on my cheekbones, on my forehead, and then down the bridges of my nose. To highlight my face today, I'll be using my Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in the color Opal. And this is just going on the high points of my cheek, down the bridge of my nose, and on my Cupid's bow. To define my contour, I'm going to be baking right underneath it with my Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder, and this is just going right underneath that contour line, and I'm just going to let it sit for a few minutes. While that's baking, I'm going back in with my Cocoa Shade from my Lorac palette, and this is just going right underneath my waterline, and I'm just going to smudge this out. For lip liner today, I'll be using my NYX Slide On, Glide On, and Stay On Lip Liner in the color Brick House. Today I'll be using my Laura Cosmetics lipstick in the color Siren. This is from their Love, Lust, and Lace Alter Ego collection. To blend in what I just baked, I'm going to be taking a big fluffy brush and blending downwards. For blush today, I'll be using my Tarte Cosmetics blush in the color Captivating, and this is just going on the apples of my cheeks. I'm then just taking that big fluffy brush that I removed my baking with, and I'm just blending in a little bit of that Laura Mercier powder onto my face. To finish off this look and set my makeup, I'll be going with my Mario Badescu Rose Water. I'm then just taking down my hair and running my fingers through it a couple times, just because I was really going more for that beachy look, not so wavy and curly. So I'm just running my fingers through it a few times just so you guys can see what it looks like. And then I'll be taking my Conair brush and just running it through it a couple times to loosen up the curls. To give my hair a little bit more volume at the tops as well, I will be going in with this teasing brush and just teasing the top a little bit. So this is the final result for this look. If you like this video, then please be sure to give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching. So you know what I realized while I was filming this? Actually, not while I was filming this. At the end, when I was like looking it over, I realized that with this poncho and with this hair, I can make myself look directly like Princess Leia, right? Just like Princess Leia. I think I look identical. It's okay. It's fun to make fun of yourself once in a while.